think a really great example of great blues is Willie Dixon. I mean, Willie Dixon, he wrote a lot of blues songs, a lot of songs that you heard. But I think this song is a great, you ever hear the 12-bar blues?
Mm-hmm. Sure.
Well, I think this is a great, great example of the 12-bar blues. It's called I Can't Quit You, Baby.
Oh, I've heard this before.
Yeah.
Good song.
All right, here we go.
A little while. Well, you done made me mess up my happy home. Made me mistreat.
Didn't recognize, anybody recognize that?
Led Zeppelin.
It was fucking Zeppelin ripped that off.
Now, you know what's great about what I really enjoyed about listening to this? Other instruments have started changing. It started evolving. You know, I don't know if jazz started influencing the blues a little bit, but if you Absolutely. Listen to the drums, because that's the first song that we listened in this episode that has featured other instruments in it, where it's recognizable to hear. Like, these drums is like those offbeat like things. And like, just listen to it. I know, did you guys ever cover this song with the Albano Red?
We covered a lot of songs.
Yeah, but
like
this song is like right up your guys' alley.
Yeah.
You know?
A lot of the songs that we played so far were these upbeat songs. I wanted to give an example of the 12-bar blues.
Yeah.
I mean, so popular. I feel like it was something we had to talk about.
No, and I think it's very important because, like I said, like I'm wondering if this is when that crossover from jazz started making its way into blues. And like it's a very important song, man.
Yeah, I think jazz is an offshoot of blues. It's like an evolution of it.
But
as the bands get bigger.
And the music becomes a little bit more complex.
I believe Willie Dixon was one of the first ones inducted to the Rock and Roll of Fame.
Okay.
He like one of the, let's say like one of the first 20 people he was inducted to the Rock and Roll of Fame.